large language models have become extremely powerful. Specifically, in math, these models have already demonstrated their capabilities in solving mathematical problems to some extent. The standard way of approaching that is using a single model inference. We feed the large language model with a problem and ask it to solve it, hoping to get the correct answer as a result. This approach is referred to as System 1 thinking. The concept of System 1 thinking comes from the book Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman, which presents System 1 and System 2 thinking as two different modes of cognitive processing that describe how humans think. System 1 is a fast, automatic, and intuitive mode of thinking that operates with little to no effort. It's used for routine tasks and decisions. On the other hand, System 2 thinking is a slow, deliberate, and conscious mode of thinking that requires intentional effort. It is used when the information presented is new, complex, or requires conscious thought. Applying this concept to solving math problems with AI, rather than providing a complete solution in a single run, the model yields multiple options for the next step in the solution. Another model then inspects the proposed options and chooses which step to take. This iterative process continues, with the model on the left yielding options for the next step and the model on the right choosing how to proceed until the final solution is achieved. Not long ago, we witnessed a dramatic breakthrough in AI with OpenAI's release of the O1 model, which demonstrated remarkable skills in solving math problems. In this video, we dive into a recent paper by Microsoft titled rStar-Math, Small LLMs Can Master Math, Reasoning with Self-Evolved Deep Thinking, which shows that small language models can rival the math reasoning capability of the O1 model by exercising System 2 deep thinking through Monte Carlo Tree Search, or MCTS in short. Let's start by understanding what Monte Carlo Tree Search deep thinking involves using the following figure from the paper. First, we have two small language models. The one on the left is in charge of generating reasoning step options. It is referred to as the policy model. The other model, on the right, is in charge of taking action by choosing the best reasoning steps. This model is referred to as the process preference model, or PPM in short. At the root of the tree, we have a math question to solve. The policy model generates options for the reasoning steps. First, it generates options for the first reasoning step. Then from each option, it generates options for the second reasoning step. The leaves are final answers, where green ones represent correct answers and red ones represent wrong answers. The path from the root question to the leaf nodes is called a trajectory. The values we see on the nodes are Q values. The Q values represent the quality of the step and are based on its contribution to reach a final correct answer. For the answer steps, correct answers are assigned a value of 1 and wrong answers are assigned a value of -1. The process preference model predicts a Q value for each step. Using rollouts, it refines the Q value. The meaning of a rollout here is to simulate what will happen if we proceed with a certain step, whether we end with a correct answer or not. We can conduct multiple rollouts and see how many times we reach a correct answer versus a wrong answer to determine the final Q value of that step. A key observation is that to develop capable policy and process preference models, we need to train the models with accurate reasoning steps and not just final answers. And it is extremely challenging to create such a dataset at scale, especially for complex math problems. To extract accurate reasoning steps, perhaps we could use a strong existing large language model. Unfortunately, when tackling complex math questions, even top large language models struggle to solve them correctly. There are two methods by which rStar-Math achieves accurate reasoning steps. The first method involves including only the reasoning steps that led to a correct answer in the Monte Carlo tree search by comparing the predicted answers with the ground truth answer labels. However, reaching a correct final answer does not guarantee that all reasoning steps were accurate. For this reason, we have a second approach, a novel method called code-augmented chain of thought. Unlike the standard chain of thought, which generates reasoning steps in natural language, the code-augmented chain of thought generates reasoning steps in natural language along with corresponding Python code for each step. Let's understand this with an example from the paper. At the top, we have a math question asking how far a person is from a certain point. Below, we see a code-augmented chain of thought reasoning. In a code comment, we have the natural language part of each step, followed by Python code. Only samples where the Python code executed successfully for all steps are kept. The reasoning steps generated as part of the Monte Carlo tree search are created using this method, which helps ensure that the intermediate steps are correct in addition to the final answer. Let's now move on to review the overall rStar-Math framework using the following figure from the paper. On the left, we see the Monte Carlo Tree Search deep thinking illustration which we reviewed earlier. Now, how do we train the policy model and the process preference model? Both models start from a pre-trained small language model. The policy model, which generates the reasoning steps, is trained using supervised fine-tuning on correct reasoning steps. These steps are extracted using Monte Carlo Tree Search with code-augmented chain of thought. The process preference model is trained using reinforcement learning. Given a search tree, we have trajectories that lead to correct answers and incorrect answers. For each step, we construct pairs of positive and negative samples. For example, in the first reasoning step, taking the right direction will lead to incorrect answer and is therefore used as the negative sample, while the left direction represents the positive example. We construct the positive and negative samples similarly for the second step. Note that the preceding path from the root is identical and we just construct positive and negative single steps added to this identical path. In practice, our trees are more complex and the selection of positive and negative samples is based on the Q values of the nodes, representing each step's contribution to a correct answer. This also helps rank multiple steps leading to a correct answer by the frequency in which taking that step results in a correct answer. For the final answer step, ideally, we would do something similar. However, it is not always possible to find samples that lead to a different answer from an identical path. In such cases, we take two trajectories for a correct answer and two wrong answer trajectories as positive and negative samples. To achieve high-quality models, the researchers suggest a recipe for self-evolved deep thinking, which consists of four rounds. The dataset used was curated to include 747,000 complex math problems with final answer ground truth labels, without reasoning steps. An important note is that it only includes competition-level problems, as simpler problems do not significantly contribute to improving complex math reasoning. Approximately 10,000 samples were collected from existing datasets, and the rest were synthesized using GPT-4. This dataset does not contain the reasoning steps needed to train both the policy model and the process preference model. The reasoning steps are generated as part of the self-evolution framework. The first round is a bootstrap phase. The pre-trained small language model is not yet capable of generating high-quality data with code-augmented chain-of-thought reasoning. Therefore, a pre-trained large language model with 236 billion parameters, DeepSeek Coder V2 Instruct, is used to generate the reasoning steps using Monte Carlo Tree Search with code-augmented chain of thought. Note that only a subset of the original dataset is actually used, since the Monte Carlo Tree Search did not yield correct answers for many of the samples in the dataset. The policy model, which is initialized from a small language model, is fine-tuned on the verified reasoning trajectories. The process preference model is also initialized from a small language model and trained in this phase using reinforcement learning. However, its quality in this phase is not good enough yet. For this reason, the Monte Carlo Tree Search is not guided by the process preference model. Instead, it is terminal guided. This means that to calculate the Q value of each step, more rollouts are needed to see how many times a certain node leads to a correct answer. Unlike when there is already a high-quality process preference model that helps to start with a valuable Q value before conducting rollouts. At the end of the first round, we have the first version of the policy model, called SLMR1. This model now serves as the policy model in the second round, replacing the large language model that was used for bootstrapping. The process preference model is still not of high quality, and therefore in this phase, we continue to conduct a terminal-guided Monte Carlo tree search. In the second round, we also generate reasoning steps for samples from the dataset and continue training both the policy model and the process preference model. In the third and fourth rounds, we use both the policy model and the process preference model that we trained up to that point to generate reasoning steps and keep training them using these generated steps. In the following table, we can see the percentage of problems that were solved correctly in each round, showing the improved capabilities as we proceed. This improvement is especially noticeable for the Olympiad-level problems. To demonstrate the value of this method, we can see in the following table three versions of rStar-Math models, each starting from a different pre-trained small language model. Impressively, the 7 billion parameters model is comparable to, and in some cases surpasses, the O1 preview and O1 mini models. If you are finding this content valuable, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button to support the channel. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You can find the link to join in the description of this video. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.